Hi everyone, Said here. I hope you are doing great. In today's lesson, we are going to learn date. We are going to learn how to write it inside Excel, how to format it, and how to use autofill for date. So, without any further ado, let's get started. To write the date inside the cell, you must separate the day, month, and year by using the slash. Look at here. By default, the format of all the cells are general. For example, I write 1/2/2023 in this cell and press Ctrl Enter to remain in the cell. Look at here. The format of the cell changes to date. All right, can you tell me what day is this day? Is it the second day of January or the first day of February? In some countries, it is the second day of January, and in some countries, it is the first day of February. But it is important to know which type of date Excel is showing you. For knowing that, first I select the cell and select the Home tab, and in the number group, I click on this arrow. You can see the different types of formats for numbers. I select long date format. Now you can see Excel's default format. It is the second day of January. If I click on this arrow again and select short date, you'll see the short type of the date, which the first character is the month, and second one is the day, and the third one is the year. But if you live in a country which has a different format for date, for example, in Europe, the first character is day, second one is month, and the third one is year. You can change the format from here. First, select the cell and then click on the little arrow in the corner of the number group. Format cell window opens. By default, the date category is selected. In the type section, you can choose between different types. Date formats that begin with an asterisk are responsive to date and time setting in your PC. But if you don't know the date and time setting of your computer, it is okay. You can set the date format according to your country inside the Excel. You can select your country format in the local locations. But I prefer United States, so I don't change it. For example, if I choose this type in the type section, you can see the preview of the date in the sample section. If I click on OK, you'll see the format of the date changes, and it is really a good format because people from all over the world won't be confused with this date. If you press Ctrl semicolon, Excel automatically writes today's date in the cell. Let me put the format of this cell to this cell. If you ever see these hash signs, it means the cell size is not large enough to show the cell content. So you can easily adjust it. If I write Jan 2023 inside the cell, it will show me the date like this, but maybe it is a little confusing for you. Is it the 23rd of January or is it January of 2023? If you look at the format of this date, it is like this, but I want it to be like this, which shows the 4-digit of the year. For changing the format of this date, let's open the cell option window again and look for this format. In the category section, I select date, so I look for that type of date in the type section. This is what we have right now. Now, we can't find the billing format here, so let me look for it in the custom section. I'm looking for a format like this, but I couldn't find it in this list too, so I type it in here. First, I delete it and I write my own format. It was MMM-4Y. You can see the preview in the sample section. If you want the full month name, you need to write 4M in here. Look. But I want the abbreviation of the month, so I write 3M. Looks good to me. So I click on OK. Now it is not confusing anymore. You can run autofill for dates too. If I run autofill to this day, by default the autofill applies on days, but if you click on the fill options, you can see different options. For better understanding, first let me change the days format to long date. Good, it is better. If I click on fill options, by default fill series has been applied to the cells, and days have been added one by one. If you select fill days, there would be no difference between the results. But if you select fill weekdays, days will add one by one, but the weekend days, Saturday and Sunday, will be eliminated from the list. If you look at the list precisely, after Friday, we have Monday. So this is what the weekdays option would do to your list. But if you select fill month, the day and year will remain constant and the month changes. And if you select fill years, only the year of the date will change. Alright, it is your turn. I want you to pause the video and write this list with the help of autofill. I hope you were able to solve this exercise. But if you couldn't, it's okay. I'll do it, and when I'm done, you try to do it yourself. I write column 1 in the cell and run autofill to the right direction. If you notice, when you are dragging, Excel is showing you a preview. How long do I have to drag? Till column 4. And in this cell, I write 1 and 2 and send them down till 12. And in this cell, I write autofill. In the next column, I write January and drag it. But I want to repeat January in all the cells, so I click on fill options and select copy cells. Be careful on these dates. Days have been increased, but I don't have the 6th and 7th of January. Let me change the format of this cell to long date format. Do you see? We don't have Saturday and Sunday. Do you know what should we do? I write the first day of January of 2024 and send it down. But in the autofill option, I select fill weekdays. Last but not least, first let me change the format of this range to long date. From this cell, I know it is Monday, so I write Monday in this cell and drag it down. But I don't want Saturday and Sunday in my list, so I click on fill option and select fill weekdays.